game if you want cubes to be companions.
Yeah. Guys that want to kill me?
There we go.
All better.
Remember, always keep one in the chamber.
Thank you.
I win.
That doesn't look good.
Yeah.
add in some new products. Find me and we'll make a deal. Yeah.
I didn't know Walter as well as you did. I'd still like to express condolences.
Just stand there. Let's do business. Now you come back if you need more murder accessories.
Oh, just look at what you're wearing.
Gabs fighting OD. Whoever wins, I win!
Sorry, just doing my job.
That's all of them. Yeah.
Open the cage, please! Thanks! Here you go!
These traps. Nice designs.
Grill cream? Hello?
He's inside. Locked. I will not be defeated by a locked door. Plan B, to the roof.
I'm a ninja breaking into a Japanese museum.
Get in here.
I'm looking for a guy named Brill Cream.
Troopmaster Brill Cream is missing.
Well, maybe I can help you find him.
Maybe you'll be lucky if I let you live.
Kind of a dick, huh?
Treason! Arrest for Kim and banish her from the troop!
Chill out, Mussolini.
I am the troop master, and this is my troop!
Man. Are you gonna tell me where Brill Cream is or what?
You wanna find Brill Cream? You must do as I say.
Oh my god, this is bad. I broke a cat. It says right on there that if you break one, you'll have a lifetime of bad luck. Unless you replace it with, like, a bunch more. I don't want bad luck for the rest of my life. You gotta help me. There's a group of scabs over by the mall. I think they might have some.
Justice, take care of that radio tower. Patient troopers over here.
Be careful. I think those scabs are using lucky cats to make bombs. How stupid is that? They're gonna have bad luck for, like, forever.
Stop! Get moving!
They're gonna want to make sure your health insurance is up to date.
I must get rid of you!
I'm coming for you, Scabs! I think I'll give these scabs a little destructive criticism.
Oh no! He's running away with that last cat!
So this is what bad luck feels like.
Hey, raise your hand if you need. I need to go over it again.
Things herkers. It's not even a word.
Glad to see you. Pretty dangerous out there, huh? Well, as long as you're out there, you mind grabbing some comics for me? I'll totally make it worth your while. I just remembered, my buddy Jason was a bus driver. I think I might have given him one. You found one. Oh man, this is great. Jason was dead, wasn't he? That's okay. Yeah, as I always say, comics are more important than friends. It'd be awesome if you could find some more, though. I'm so stupid. I can't believe I forgot about Trina. She used to be my girlfriend, but then we had this super big blow-up about Captain Thunder's origin story and whatever. I was right. Anyway, she worked at the hotel. You won't believe it. I remembered who I gave one to. It was this guy, Terry. Kind of sketchy. And the BO on that guy. Jesus. I think he joined a gang of scabs. I borrowed some comics from this guy, Anton. Then I lent them to some of my friends, but I forgot which friends, and this guy, Anton, he's gonna kill me if he finds out I don't have his comics. Seriously, I think he, like, kills people for a living.
Oh,
remember, I have this buddy, Mike, who works construction. Huge comic geek. Like, every day at lunch, he would go read at the same place. So, maybe he left it there? I just remembered, Anton was right next door the whole time. Sorry. Anyway, come get your reward. Hey, I was thinking about this whole apocalypse thing. So, lots of people died, and it's really sad. So, why should their comics go to waste, right? A bunch of our regular customers had really good collections, and they lived in the area. So go rescue those lonely comics.
Thank you.
grab. I want to savor the first smell.
Not now!
Their comic addiction from their mom. That makes total sense to me. Okay, that's everyone on the list. Bring them back and I'll get them all in slipcovers.
Big time!
Okay, that's a wrap on guys that want to kill me.
Thanks for saving me!
Found this in the back closet. It'll totally make you look like a superhero. You can be like the superhero who liberates comic books during the mutant apocalypse. That would be an amazing comic. Hey, I got this story idea. Check it out. Okay, you're the Comic Knight, upholder of the comics code and defender of comics in the apocalypse. What do you think? It's awesome, huh? I draw it up, but I can't draw or write. But I love reading. I got some leads on some more. You know, if you're truly the hero this city needs. shipped out a bunch of books the week before the city turned. As Comic Knight, it's really your duty to liberate them from the clutches of the enemy and return them to good owners. Thank me.
I think you should stick with Comic Knight.
Yeah, cool. Okay. The Comic Knight saves more luscious mint pages from the grips of Gross City villains. Gross City is such a terrible name. I need a good name for what Sunset City has become. Something, I don't know, like darker, like Twilight City. Oh man, that's good. Yeah, and it appeals to girls too. Your comic is going to be such a hit. Story. Now, is it a little far-fetched if your parents died and you were raised by reading comics? Magic comic and a mission to save the comics of Twilight City. The story needs more.
How about a villain?
Yes, a villain. Someone who hates comics, like my ex. Just kidding. Not really. I just never had a girlfriend, whatever. Anyway, I gotta think about this. Just keep up that first edition Justice comic night. I mean, think about what would happen if her musty mildewness ever got near your magic comic. Who knows if kitty litter and baking soda could even bring the magic back.
We'll be right back.
if your magic comic ever gets musty, you can always collect more comics to restore your power. Then we can have a whole series of comeback issues building up to a climactic fight. This could easily be 100 plus issues. When she needed you most, but you were too busy reading comics the day she drowned.
Is this art imitating life here?
Any connections here are purely coincidental. This is a monumental tragedy. I mean, she blames the comics. And maybe you secretly blame,
myself?
Oh, no way. No. What? No. How could you have known she was suffering all that time? Come on, get back on board with this.
No more ammo!
Now, you ready for this ending?
Definitely not.
So in order to defeat Musty Mildew, the Comic Knight has to sacrifice the very thing he loves most.
The Super Mint Magic Comic.
Yeah. How did you know? Huh. I guess you are the Comic Knight.
Yeah, and I'm not doing it. I've got comics to save. No way I'm giving up my powers for moldy old love.
Wow, you're such an anti-hero. There's so much truth in this art. I'm done collecting. I've got to get to writing all this down. And you, good luck out there, Comic Knight. One man in this town believes in you.
Herker.
Nah, too much work.
Huh.
ran out of ammunition. Hope you're doing something worthwhile with it. That gun is reliable, creative, and works very hard for you, like me. Remember, always keep one in the chamber.
Take care of that radio tower.
I have the That top is so cheap and gaudy. Oh, darling, it's so you.
Take care of that radio tower. We've got impatient troops.
My troop has been trying to locate Troopmaster Brillcream via radio, but all they hear is this.
Doctors recommend drinking 17 cans of Overcharge a day.
The radio station is located here. If you destroy all three transmitters around the tower, we have a better chance of locating Troopmaster Brillcream. So, you think you can do that?
Sure thing. Be right back.
What is that?
Like this?
Sweet. I didn't even have to check game facts.
You guys look tough. Transmitters blew up so big. Holy shit. Looks like that killed the hornet's nest.
Nice!
Drink it now or drink it later. Over.
Okay! Who wants to be first?
Sorry, Mr. Transmitter. Nothing personal.
The circle of life ends in overcharge.
Up we go.
Hey, it's me, Fizzy. Trespassing and destruction of property is a serious crime. Get ready to die, asshole.
A giant whip is attacking me. This Coke's marketing is getting really aggressive.
Hey, you know what sounds like fun? If you stop for a second. Today is Laser Appreciation Day. Let's celebrate. You think you're hurting me, but you're not. Don't you dare bounce on those satellites.
Entire family of assholes. Sorry, Dave. I'm afraid.
Norton, fixed your radio for you.
What? You're alive?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lose to a blimp. That'd be humiliating.
Well, my troop thanks you for your service. Goodbye.
Wait. You'll let me know if you find Brill Cream, right?
Oh, yes, Brill Cream, of course. We'll keep looking for it. Thank you again.
Hey, it's Sam. Come back to our base. There's someone here that wants to talk with you. And she's kind of cute.
Sam, I found this thing. I think it came out of that fizzy blimp. Look familiar to you?
Get out! That's Fizzy's AI core! I bet it's full of Fizco secrets! Let me try to remotely connect to it. Frack! It needs to be plugged into the Fizco network somehow. It's using a 512-bit land slave triple hash encryption algorithm. Oh, if only there was a Fizco network plugin somewhere.
There's a fizzy fortune machine over there. Want me to ask it for help?
You're a genius! Bring the core over to the fizzy fortune machine! Drop it there. That's it! Okay, gotta go fast before it locks me out. Hold on to your butts.
Whoa, it's tweaking out or something.
This is some seriously messy code. Give me a couple more seconds. Compiling now.
Did you make it scream like that?
Maybe. I don't know why it turned back on, but it did.
You killed me, asshole! What did you do with my body? Are you carrying me? Ah, keep your hands off me! I'm being molested over here! Didn't have enough, huh? Give me a balloon! Just what? I'll finish the job! Where are we going? I'm upside down, you moron! Help me, don't you put me back in there!
Keep hacking, Sam. Looks like the fizz is onto us.
Fizzy was programmed to hate people who don't drink Overcharge. That's no surprise. This code is really messy. Where is the variable?
Even declare. Oh, God.
Out here, something about an empathy chip. Ah, so close! There's another busy fortune machine close by.
You're supposed to be dead. And my name isn't Asshole.
Oh, really? What is it then?
I don't know. It floats above my head in moments.
And I'm in. Oh, first things first. Removing the comments around this empathy chip.
Stop typing in there! What? What is this? My morals hurt.
He's crying Overcharge? How is that possible? Make him stop crying, Sam! Hurry!
I'm trying!
Why? Why would someone make such an evil robot like me?
Was commented out for a reason. There's gotta be some secret stuff in there. Take him to another machine.
It's all my fault. The poor mutated children.
Oh, damn it, I kind of feel bad for him now. Sam, why did you have to mess with my emotions like, I mean his emotions like that?
It's either this or he's a complete psychopath. Ugh, who would design such a terrible program? Yeah. Okay, plug him in and we'll see if we can shut him up.
What's the point of it all? I'm a monster and I deserve to get my face melted off. I'm gonna blow myself up and I'm taking you with me, asshole.
Sam?
Crap! I'm locked out. Take him to another machine, quick.
What are you worried about? You're all gonna die anyway. Every single one of you, with your fancy clothes and non-inflatable mouth holes. You know what green looks like? Me, the happiest balloon alive that does nothing but kill, kill, kill. I thought we were friends, and then you melted my face off.
Just in time. He's fully deactivated. Okay, now, where was I? Oh my god!
What?
No wonder he's insane! Fizzy was designed and coded by a focus group! A focus group of robots!
That's right. 20 elite focus group bots. Programmed to program, and programmed to kill. Humans cannot measure fun, as they cannot agree on what is fun. We were built with a fun sensor, and we detect that you are not fun, and therefore you must die. Did you enjoy Fizzy's red lasers? Psychologists agree that the color red makes consumers salivate. To focus test properly, we programmed ourselves to be robots. I'm gonna smoke your ass, bro. clouds are... Market research says balloons are fun. Release balloons for maximum fun. Robot focus groups are never wrong. Robots agree that do not pop our balloon, then say Fizzy's voice is perfectly pitched to appeal to infants and males in their mid-20s. Robot focus groups are 28% more accurate than rodent focus groups, but 36% less useful for testing skin products. Focus groups are 28% worse. Combat ever. Row 1 out of 5 stars. You suck.
Well, that was weird. Come back to the machine. I'm about to reboot Fizzy. Except for his empathy chip. He might not even turn on.
What? What? What have you... My thoughts are clear. I know what I am. I was made to sell a product that kills people.
Well, technically, you just mutate them.
I should have never existed. Please, cast me into the bay and drown my memory into oblivion.
Sam, what do I do?
I don't know, but he has a point. The world is better off without him.
Go on, into the water with me. Perhaps a fish. I know now why you cry, but it's something I can never do. Thank you, asshole.
Appreciate it. Thanks for saving my skin.
Be careful out there, it's dangerous. And I don't want to lose you.
Oh, honey, it looks like you're wearing a poor person costume.
Hey, hey, hey. You know that big parking garage in old little Tokyo? It's packed with all kinds of electronics we could totally use. But it's scab turf. You know what? You could lure some OD over there to help take care of the scabs. My sociology prof said passive-aggressive warfare is the future.
Huh?
Gandhi once said, an eye for an eye will only make the whole world blind. I mean, I'm not saying you need to be Gandhi or the Dalai Lama or whatever. Just pointing out that sometimes there might be a more effective way of getting what you want. Other than shooting everything in the face, that is. You'll need to smash some vending machines and set off some car alarms. Look for more cars or vending machines. working. Electronics. That Forkim chick is smart.
My name is Forkim.
Hey, sorry about that whole banished from the troop thing.
It's for the best. Troopmaster Norton is a bad guy. Even though he says he's trying to find Brill Cream, he's not. I overheard him whisper something about Troopmaster Brill Cream at the hot dog factory.
I hear this Brill Cream guy is really smart.
He's a genius.
A genius that might be trapped in a hot dog factory?
I'm worried. He's been missing for a couple of weeks.
We'll find him.
You mean I'll find him?
Someone has to stay here and comfort Forkim.
Right. Keep up the good work, Sam.
Sam? I had a buddy who used to beat him up in school.
Before you run into trouble.
Pretty sure he's dead now, though.
pizza.
That gun was destined for the chosen one. But I guess you can have it.
So what's the deal with the hot dog factory? If you're trying to survive the apocalypse, hot dogs are the last thing you should eat.
Troop Master Brill Cream is a master at boosting morale. Maybe he thought a hot dog cookout would lift the spirits of the troop.
Oh, that's funny, because I prefer to lift my spirits with actual spirits.
Alcohol is a depressant and has many health risks.
You're right. Better to eat processed pig lips and assholes. So that's healthy. Okay, I'm at the hot dog factory.
Look around for signs of Troop Master Brill.
Scabs. And it looks like they decided to upgrade their arsenal.
Where did they get those new weapons? They're not smart enough to design them on their own. You might have to deal with some scabs while you look for evidence.
Think? Scabs and evidence go together like...
Found a Japanese sword. Not something a troop leader would have.
Seems weird, doesn't it? But it could be Brill Cream's. He never went anywhere without it.
I feel like that could have been useful intel to have on top of this caper.
But we need more evidence.
Huh, a troop leader's hat. Seems like something a troop leader would wear.
That could be Brill Cream's. He was always wearing his hat. I think we just need...
Found a bugle? Now that would only be something a troop leader would have, right?
Brill Cream carried a bugle, sometimes. But I'm not sure why he would have brought that with him.
Yeah, you're right. This could be anyone's bugle.
Okay, I'm convinced. Either Brill Cream is here, or he was here. You should check inside the factory. Brill Cream is a trained survivalist. He may have locked himself inside. See if you can find a way to bust down a door, or even a wall.
Door's locked.
Is there any construction equipment around? Anything that might help you get inside?
Yep. I gotta eat more.
Whoa! Look who wants
me. Use the crane to bust down the wall.
No keys. Wait, cranes have keys? Huh. What would Batman do? Probably read this note out loud. Meet me in the park for a picnic. I love you. Well, that's helpful. Guess I'm going to the park to look for some keys. And maybe even have a date. Hey, for Kim. Sam's not being too annoying, is he?
Not anymore. He kept trying to hold my hand, so I put my judo badge into action and snared him in a rear naked choke.
Nice. But go easy on him. I get the sense he doesn't have much experience with the ladies.
Well, he's been a perfect gentleman since. He showed me around, I fed his bread. He even taught me how to do a little C++ coding.
Wow, you sure to invite me to the wedding. I love free food.
Wait, what?
Okay, I found the picnic site. Looks like the crane guy either turned OD or was mauled. Damn, I need those keys to the crane.
If we're lucky, he turned OD. Go kill some and see if any of them have the key.
Ah, just what I need. Fizco bots. Hey, Fort Kim, you there?
Yes. Did you find the key?
Yeah, but I have something more important to talk about.
Okay.
So what do you think of Sam? Really?
I don't know why, but he kind of reminds me of this class turtle we had in fourth grade. We set him free in the ocean one day. Then we found out later that he was a freshwater turtle.
Don't tell Sam that story. Destroy stuff in a crane again. Let's see, what can I destroy? Damn it, those pallets were actually overcharged deliveries. Now this place is about to be stupid with OD. Good thing I have
godlike crushing power.
I better crush those OD before they turn into poppers. Found a note from Brill Cream. It's dated 2 weeks ago.
What does it say?
It says, hot dog spoiled, heading to Hepcats to meet Norton. Scabs on my trail, we'll try to lose them.
Let's meet at Hepcats and look for more clues. I knew Norton was involved somehow.
Troopmaster Norton?
Hey, Norton. How's that search for Brill Cream going?
Not good. I believe it's time to call it off.
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream. He said he was going to meet you at Hepcat's Diner. Whatever happened with that?
Well, as I recall, he never showed up. Where did you find that note?
You're lying, Norton. What are you hiding?
How dare you? A troop master never lies. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to. Meet me at Hepcat's Diner. I think Forkim could be in trouble.
On my way.
Troop Master Norton.
Hey, Norton. How's that search for Brill Cream going?
Not good. I believe it's time...
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream. He said he was going to meet you at Hepcat's Diner. Whatever happened with that?
Well, as I recall, he never showed up. Where did you find that note?
Hey,
you're lying, Norton. I need to work on my maritime badges. Scabs on the whole waterfront.
A troop master never lies.
Can you run them out of there?
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to.
You get rid of them, and the next day they've all just respawned. Unless... Okay, I got an idea. First things first. I need to find a herker. It needs to be a really ugly one. Yeah. Time to scare these scabs off. Permanently.
What the hell is that?
I'm gonna eat you alive!
Oh my god! Motherfucker!
If the police, we can kill it!
It's Legion, we can't kill it!
Your liver with some lima beans and a nice Merlot!
Regroup further down the waterfront! We can take it if we stand together!
What the fucking fuck is that thing?
Get out of here! This is my turf!
No! It's an abomination!
Stay away from the waterfront or I'll come back!
Scared them all away. They're never coming back after that. Thank you so much.
Sure thing. It was fun. Guess it backfired a little.
Back off! I'm not one of you!
Troop Master Norton?
Hey, Norton. How's that search for Brill Creek go?
Not good. I believe it's time to call it out.
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream. He said he was going to meet you at Heptad's Diner. Whatever happened with that?
Well, as I recall, he never showed up. Where did you find that note?
I'm lying, Norton. What are you hiding?
How dare you? A troop master never lies. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to. I think Orkin could be in trouble.
On my way.
Smoke signals at the train station could be Brill Cream's. But I saw a bunch of scabs going after her. You gotta get up there.
Wait here.
I'm trying to contact Forkim, but her phone is dead. Oh, I hope she's okay.
She probably turned her phone off. Either that or she's sick of your constant texting. Did she at least go armed?
She's always prepared. She had a baseball bat and a book on how to tie knots.
Clever girl. I'm at the bottom of the station. Looks like a whole scab legion is occupying this place.
Thank you.
assuming that's you downstairs.
Yes, it's me. Being me.
Good. Keep doing what you're doing. You're a very good distraction. The scabs are leaving the platform. This is my chance to rescue Brylcreem.
Can you see him?
No, but...
Get her on the train and don't hurt her! He'll want her alive!
Brylcreem's not here! It's a...
Crap!
This thing. Can't let that train get out of my sights. Back on its ass. Oh yeah, those thrusters don't look too safe. Bullets in its belly could create a nice fireworks show. Need to get a bead on those thrusters. That'll slow the train down.
Brylcreem is in a garbage truck, but they didn't know where.
Garbage truck, huh? And the whole garbage system is automated. The trucks are equipped with GPS transmitters. If you come back to our base, I might be able to figure out a way to track it down.
Okay, cool. I'm on my way. Wait, how do we communicate with Sam when neither of us is holding a phone?
Technology.
Technology.
Let's not complicate things by poking holes in the way we deliver the story, okay?
Oh, okay then. I'm gonna go back to the base and be magically gone by the time you have control.
Fine by me. That's not weird at all.
Hey, man, I found a new place to set up shop. More square footage, better feng shui. Come on over whenever you get a chance.
I learned a few other things while I was interrogating those scabs.
They said they were working with...
A letter? For me?
Want to uncover the truth behind Overcharge? The real truth? Wait for my call at the dog park.
Ooh, sounds intriguing. Better head to the dog park.
New fashion show, Megan.
Is that a phone booth or a public toilet? Or both? Hello?
Were you followed?
I don't think so.
Listen close. We're gonna blow the lid off this whole conspiracy. Fisco was supposed to burn all the top secret memos, but one of their admins dropped some into recycling bins instead. Those bins are now inside recycling trucks parked around the city. Get the memos and bring them to the dead drop location.
This is some serious spy movie action. This would be way better with some spy movie music. Now that's more like it. It's nice to see them killing people who aren't me for a change.
Alarm engaged. Recycling truck in lockdown mode.
Hey, robot!
Hey, sensors over.
I'm an artist who works in Fizz Corpses.
Unauthorized access. Again, you don't learn very well, do you? Recycling waste for you.
Another letter.
Drop the memos off in the dumpster. I'll process them and set up another meeting. We're gonna make Fisco pay for what they did to us.
Okay. Hope Mr. Mysterious knows what he's doing.
Hey man, I think I figured out a way to upgrade these vats. See, if we add some freon-based cooling actuators and reverse the ionic charge of blah, 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 science and bullshit, just go find some old refrigerators and bring me some spare parts.
Thank you.
have hideout on the bridge. It's okay to kill them because they're criminals. And because they yell mean things at me. Scab hideout on the bridge. It's okay to kill them because they're criminals. And because they yell mean things at me.